offline class. This is online class in virtual mode. So you are writing in which copy. This is not mandatory because you have to send it a soft copy. You are not submitting your hard copy so that you will write it in a copy you have to write it in A4 sheet. That means you have to send a soft copy. So this is not mandatory for you that you are writing in copy or A4 sheet. So don't ask this type of question letter, but you have to carry that these things with you, because letter from soft copy you can't read properly. So hard copy is needed for you, not for me. So do whatever you want to do. That if you are want to write in copy, then okay. If you are wanting to write in A4 sheet, then also okay. So no problem for me. But only what I have seen, that only 6 students have submitted the assignment. So do it fast. Only 6. Roll number 1.
Yes, ma'am.
Roll number 2. Roll number 2.
Present, ma'am.
3.
Present, ma'am.
4.
Present, ma'am.
5.
Present, ma'am.
6.
Present, ma'am.
7. Roll number 7.
Present, ma'am.
8. Nine.
Present, ma'am.
10.
Present, ma'am.
11.
Present, ma'am.
12.
Present, ma'am.
13.
Present, ma'am.
14.
Present, ma'am.
15.
Present, ma'am.
16.
Present, ma'am.
17.
Present, ma'am.
18.
Present, ma'am.
19.
Present, ma'am.
20.
Present, ma'am.
21.
Present, ma'am.
22.
Present, ma'am.
23.
Present, ma'am.
24.
Present, ma'am.
25.
Present, ma'am.
26. 27.
Present, ma'am.
28.
Present, ma'am.
29.
Present, ma'am.
30.
Present, ma'am.
31.
Present, ma'am.
32.
Present, ma'am.
33. Roll number 33. Absent. Roll 33. So 33 is absent. 34. Roll number 34. 34 is again absent. 34.
35. Present, ma'am.
36.
Present, ma'am.
37.
Present, ma'am.
38.
Present, ma'am.
39.
Present, ma'am.
40.
Present, ma'am.
41.
Yes.
42. 42.
Yes,
43.
Yes, ma'am.
Present, ma'am.
44.
Yes, ma'am.
45.
Present ma'am.
Okay, so roll number 33 and 34 are absent. Moon. Is the sharing screen visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So I have completed gradient, divergence, and curl, and the problems on these topics. Okay. Now today, I will discuss vector integration. Vector integration means line integration, surface integration, and volume integration. So first, line integration. Let DL be an element of length on a smooth curve PQ. So you can see PQ is the curve. So this is the line integration. So PQ is the curve and DL, it is shown here, DL be an element of length on a smooth curve PQ. So this is an element of length. So this is line element and this is the curve PQ. And A be continuous vector point function. And this is, I am taking vector point function A. The scalar product of A with the line element DL. So the scalar product of A with the line element DL is called the line integral of the vector A. So the scalar product of A, scalar product of A with the line element DL. So what is this? This is A dot DL. This is called the line integral of the vector A. So this is the line integral of vector A, and for an extended path, it will be equal to the integral. And if we can take the whole part, that is from P to Q, then P to Q, A dot DL, that is equal to P to Q, A DL cos theta. So this is P to Q, A DL, and we can write this as A dot DL as A DL cos theta. So the integration becomes P to Q, A DL cos theta. So this is the line integral. So over the whole path, P to Q, and this is the dot product of A and DL. So the line element DL, so the scalar product or the dot product, the scalar product of A with the line element DL. What is this? This is A dot DL. Over the path, what is the path? P to Q. So line integration of A dot DL over the path P to Q, integration P to Q, that I can write equal to P to Q, and A dot DL, that I can write A DL cos theta. Now it is defined as the line integral of the vector A along the curve PQ, where theta is the angle between A and elementary length DL. So theta is the angle between A and elementary length DL. So in terms of components of A along the three Cartesian coordinates, we have now what is A dot DL? A vector that is written as I hat AX plus J hat AY plus K hat AZ. Dot, what is DL? DL I am writing as I hat DX plus J hat DY plus K hat DZ. Now A dot DL, I have written this is A and this is DL. Now the dot product of these two, what I am getting? AX, DX, then what? AY, DY, plus AZ, DZ. So that is equal to P to Q, AX, DX, plus ay dy plus az dz. So if the path of integration is a closed curve, then we write this symbol instead of this symbol. So if this is the symbol of closed path, so if the path of the integration is closed, then we will write this integration in place of this integration sign, we will write this sign. So closed path integration p to q, then ax dx plus ay dy plus az dz. So this is the line integration of this. Now if the value of the line integral depends only on the initial and final points in the vector field and it is independent of path, then the vector field is called conservative field. All central force fields such as gravitational field, electrostatic field are conservative fields. For conservative fields, it satisfies this one, that is closed surface integration A dot dl that is equal to zero. If the line integral over a closed path in a vector field A is zero, then A will be the gradient of the scalar psi. And if A is conservative, then remember curl of A is zero. So if A is conservative field, then and remember this one, if the line integral over a closed path in a vector field A is zero, then A will be the gradient of the scalar function, that is A will be grad psi, where psi is the scalar point function. And for conservative field, curl of A that is equal to zero. Now coming to surface integration, if S be outward surface of a body placed in a vector field A, and if n hat be an outward drawn unit normal to an element of surface ds. So see, this is the surface ds, and n hat, this is the direction of n hat, and n hat is what? N hat be an outward drawn unit normal. So this is outward drawn unit normal upon the surface ds, such that we can write ds vector that is equal to n hat ds. So here what I have drawn, S be the outward surface of a body placed in a vector field. S is the total surface. Now here ds is a small surface we have drawn, and there n hat is the outward drawn unit normal to the element of surface ds, such that ds that is equal to such that ds equal to n hat ds vector that is equal to n hat into ds. This is not vector. So as I have written here n hat unit vector, so I'm not giving here vector sign, so I'm writing like this. And this is the xyz axis, three axes are shown, and projection of ds on xy plane, it is shown. Projection of ds, this is the area dx dy, ds is here. So what is the area here? Dx dy, the area here it is dx and here it is dy. So ds is here, dx dy. So this is the projection of ds in xy plane. Actually ds is here, but I'm taking the projection. So here the projection comes and it is on the xy plane. So as it is in the xy plane, so what will be our area here? It is xy plane, so it is dx dy. If it is yz plane, then dx will be dy dz. If it is xz plane, then dy will be what? It is xz plane, then dx dz. So in this way we can write, where ds is the vector area of ds, this is a vector area of ds. So mod of ds, that it is written as this. The outward flux of the continuous vector function A through DS, it is written as DN, that is equal to A dot DS. The total outward flux through the whole surface is, so what is the total outward flux? So DN is this. So from here, if we integrate, we will get N from this. So integrating over DN, so we will get N. So again, integrating over here, so total outward flux through the whole surface is, this is surface integration. So double integration is shown. So double integration, that is the surface integration. Surface integration A dot DS. So surface integration A dot DS, that is equal to surface integration of what is DS? DS vector. What is this N DS vector? It is written
N hat into DS.
Yes. Okay. So DS vector N hat DS. So I have written, so the total outward flux through the whole surface is, that is equal to N, that is surface integration A dot DS, then surface integration A dot N hat DS. And remember, double surface integration is double integration. You have to remember, line integration is single integration. Sign, if single integration sign you have to give, but in surface integration, double integration sign you have to give. And if you calculate the volume integration, then triple integration sign you have to give. So this is the total outward flux through the whole surface S, and it is given by N equal to N equal to surface integration A dot DS, that is equal to surface integration of A dot N hat DS. Just a minute. So total flux, that is A equal to surface integration. Now next, volume integration. If A is a single valued continuous vector function in volume V enclosed by a surface S, then the volume integral of A is given by what? Volume integration of A dV. And what is A? Tell me, what is A? What is vector A?
A1 xi plus A1 xi
hat plus A2 y j hat plus A3 k hat. Okay, k hat. So I have given, and what is V? And dV is here, everywhere. dV. So volume integration of A dV, that is equal to what? This one. So this is the volume integration. Now this theorem is very important. The divergence theorem of Gauss, Gauss divergence theorem. Remember this one. The Gauss divergence theorem states that if V is the volume bounded by a closed surface S, so V is the volume bounded by a closed surface S. So V is bounded by closed surface S, and A is the vector function of position with continuous derivatives, then volume integration of what is this? What I will say? This? Say anyone? How I will say this one? Volume integration, what is this?
That, ma'am.
Divergence of A dV.
So volume integration of divergence of A dV, that is equal to what? Surface integration of A dot N hat DS. A dot N hat DS. And now it is bounded by a closed surface S as it is. So I have written like this, closed surface. Then N hat DS, that I can write it as DS vector. So N hat DS, that I can write it as DS vector. So actually, Gauss divergence theorem relates the volume integration and surface integration. If we can convert a volume integration to a surface integration or a surface integration to a volume integration using the Gauss divergence bounded by a closed surface S. So Gauss divergence theorem is valid for closed surface, and this is the relation. We will use this relation later in many cases, that is in the when I will discuss Maxwell's equations, then every step you need this formula. So Gauss divergence changes the volume integration to surface integration or the surface integration to volume integration. So we can relate if any integration is vector integration is given, and in surface integration it is difficult to calculate, then in the same way using the Gauss divergence theorem, what we can do, we can convert the surface integration to volume integration, and then we can calculate, and the answer you will get same. If this condition is satisfied, then if you calculate in surface, the answer you will get, what answer you will get, the same answer you will get when you will calculate in volume. So this is the Gauss divergence theorem. This relates the volume integration and the surface integration, but the surface is closed surface here, where n hat is a positive outward drawn normal to S. So n hat, what is n hat? N hat is a positive outward drawn normal to S. So this is Gauss divergence theorem. Then next, Stokes theorem. Two theorems in vector, from vector calculus you may or may not get problems, vector integration from this part, but later in every step in Maxwell equation, in magnetostatics, in electrostatics, these two theorems are very important, because in every step you have to use this condition, that is Gauss divergence theorem, and here I'm discussing Stokes theorem. Now Stokes theorem states that if S is an open surface, so this is the difference between the two, that is Stokes theorem and Gauss divergence theorem. In Gauss divergence theorem, what was the surface? This was a closed surface, but here it is open surface. Two-sided surface bounded by a closed non-intersecting curve C, simple closed curve, then A has continuous derivatives, and we can surface integration. It relates the line integration to surface theory. A line integration A dot dr over the contour C, A dot dr, that we can write it equal to surface integration of curl of A dot n hat ds. So this is the formula, that is the theorem, Stokes theorem. A dot dr line integration, that is equal to surface integration curl of A dot n hat ds, and this n hat ds I have written as ds. So C is the traversed in the positive direction. The direction of C is called the positive. If the observer walking on the boundary of S in this direction with his head pointing in the direction of the positive normal to S as the surface on his left. So only just remember for this for your syllabus, only remember this theorem, Stokes theorem, and this converts the line integration to surface integration. Remember this one. And this is for where S is an open surface. Now I'm coming here to this problem. Problem number one. So what is this? This problem is the line integration problem. Particular this problem is given in your exam, offline exam, many times. Okay, so what is the question? Find the total work done in moving a particle in a force field is given by F is given, and along the curve x equal to t square plus 1, y equal to 2t square, and z equal to tq from t equal to 1 to t. So you have to work done. And what is the formula of work done? Do you know this formula? Dw equal to F dot dr?
Yes, ma'am.
Force into displacement. Dr, displacement. F dot dr. So dw. So we know the work done by a force in displacing a particle through a small distance dr, dw, this is what? F dot dr. Okay. Now I'm going to whiteboard. call the roll number of 43 showing, who is that roll number? The whiteboard is visible or not?
Visible, ma'am.
Whiteboard is visible or not?
Visible, ma'am.
Students?
Visible, ma'am.
Ma'am, visible.
Yes, ma'am, visible.
Visible.
I'm not getting any answer. Is it visible?
Yes, ma'am, visible.
Ma'am, visible.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So what is F? What is F? F equal to, just I'm calculating here, 3xy I hat. 3xy I hat. Then minus 5z j hat. Plus 10x k hat. Is it this F? F equal to 3x I hat minus 5z j hat plus 10x k hat. And it is given along the curve. X equal to what? T square plus 1. Then y equal to 2t square and z equal to what? T cube. Is it? Mm-hmm. And from where you have to calculate? From t equal to 1, 2. What? T equal to 2. What do you have to calculate? What you have to calculate? F dot dr.
Work.
So what you have to calculate? F dot dr. But the limit is given in terms of t. The limit is given in terms of t. So you can't calculate in terms of dx dy dz or in terms of dx dy dz. So whole thing, the whole problem you have to convert into in terms of in terms of t. So F you have to convert in terms of t. Dx, dy, dz, you have to convert in terms of t. So for that, what I am writing, going to next slide. Now, what is this? X equal to what? T square plus 1. Okay, x equal to t square plus 1. So how you can write dx? So what is dx if you calculate? Say, what is dx?
2t.
Then?
2t.
With that?
Dt.
Dt. Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Y equal to 2t square.
Yes, ma'am.
Y equal to 2t square. Take your pen and paper and calculate yourself. If you just watching this, then you will have problem later. Do it yourself. What I'm doing, do it in your copy. So dy, what is dy?
40
dt.
40 dt. Okay. Is it? And what is z cube? What is given? Z equal to 2 cube. Z equal to t cube. Z equal to? T cube. What is dz?
3t square dt.
3t
square dt.
Is it? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, why I have done this? Because what I have to write? I have to write what? F dot dr. Okay. So F is what? 3x y. sorry, I hat. 3xy? What? I hat. Then minus 5z. J hat. Plus 10x. K hat. Okay. Then dot product of which? This is dot product. What is dr? Dx I hat plus dy j hat plus dz k hat. Just a minute. Hello, can you listen, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Is it okay what I have written?
Yes, ma'am.
Is it okay what I have written? Okay. Then what from this step what I can write? 3xy dx, is it? Then
yes,
what? Say then what? If you take the dot product of these two, what you can write?
Minus 5z dy.
Minus 5z dy. Then last one.
Plus
10x.
Last one.
Plus 10x dz.
Yes.
Plus 10x dz.
10x dz. Okay. Now it is written like this. Then what is the next task? What you will do? You will just convert this x, y, z to t and dx, dy, dz in terms of t and put the limit in terms of t. Okay. Understand what I'm saying?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then put the value of x. What is the value of x? What is the x? T square plus 1. So what you will write in this place? Say, I'm just doing this. Just do it in your copy. I'm just also calculating here. So going to the next slide. So dw equal to what? So what was there? 3xy dx. Okay. Now you will tell me. 3xy. What is x?
T square plus 1.
Okay. Then y. Y is what?
2t square.
Dt, from where you are getting a dt? Y equal to what? Y equal to 2t square.
Yes, ma'am.
So 3xy, then dx. Okay. What is dx?
2t dt.
Okay. So this one, t equal to what? 1, 2, 2. Okay. So this is the part. Then minus of what? 5z dy. I'm writing separately so that you don't have any problem. 5 is written outside the integration sign. Then what? Inside the z dy. What is this? What is z? Z is what?
T cube.
Then dy. Dy is what?
40 dt.
Okay. Now the last term. 10. t equal to 1 to 2 what is 10 at 10 in outside then x dz what is x
t square plus 1 into okay. 3 t square dt
t plus 1 then
3 t square
dz dt. Equal to what
3 t square dt
okay is it okay now now can you differentiate integrate this one so just yes, multiply ma'am. And then do it here though it is 4 3 4 is a 12 12 is outside then what is remaining next t square plus y here it is t cube and here it is t square so t to the power 5 plus t cube okay then dt integrate it is easier now for you okay any problem
no ma'am
so here what is the second portion what you will do it is 4 t to the power 4 so 4 put it outside so 4 5 is 20 and here it is t to the power 4 dt integrate t to the power 4 so what is this t to the power 5 by 5 put the limit t equal to 1 to 2 in this way calculate the whole thing okay so in this way just calculate you will get now I am going to my original ppt slide this is actually the whiteboard slide and here I have discussed how to calculate so this was the problem so f was this and x y z the values are given in terms of t you have to integrate over t to t equal to 1 to 2 so I have calculated f dot dr and what I have in this way I have calculated I have converted x y z in terms of t then dx dy dz in terms of t so all the values are given here now ultimately getting this one now going to the original ppt now see this one so if you calculate in this way so understand how it is done we're getting the value of putting the value of x y here and dx in terms of there so if you calculate you will get in this way so answer is what 303 is it so if this type of problem you will get and especially this problem is very important especially this problem is very important so the work done remember f dot dr so this type of problem f you will get dr you will get so only the formula of work done w equal to f dot dr integration that you have to remember and that is important here that if you can integrate if you can integrate properly then you can do this problem so only integration is necessary for this now this condition is given x equal to this y equal to this z equal to this so this may be different as some another relation other relation may be given so you know how to calculate so you can do it okay students are you calculating this problems now or only copying or just watching the ppt
calculating ma'am
calculate yourself and this that will solve your problem otherwise when you will try to calculate later may have problem so for your that understanding is your understanding I'm just using the whiteboard and I just calculating all the problems there it is already given in ppt but I am also doing the steps so whenever I am doing the steps in the whiteboard just do your calculation in your own copy now this is the problem of surface integration so actually what is the time remaining because this is a big problem 43 so can I okay here show that surface integration of r dot n hat ds that is equal to 3 over the entire surface s of the unit cube bounded by the coordinate planes x equal to 1 y equal to 1 z equal to 1 So this problem, it is done by surface integration, and the same problem So the same problem I'm just using in whiteboard. So this problem, surface integration of r dot n hat ds equal to 3, and x, y, z values are given like this. So you have to find the value and you have to prove it is 3. Now, I'm just drawing the cube first, huh? This is not, I can't do it properly. So what is this? X axis. And what is this? Y. And what is this? This is Z axis. Now giving the name. This is G. This is F. This is C. This is B. This is O. This is A. E. And this is D. Actually, this line will pass through the point D. So whenever you are writing in your copy, just correct it, this portion. So these are the names. So what now? The surface. Now OABC, that surface I'm taking. OA, this is O, this is A, this is B, and this is C. OABC, this surface. So what is this surface? This is O, this is A, B, C. This is the surface. OABC is the surface. Now there, what is N hat? I say first, tell me, on OABC surface, what is DS? OABC, what is DS?
DY into DZ.
So DS is DY DZ. Okay. So OABC, this is the surface. Now here, DS equal to DY DZ. So what is our formula here? That is surface integration of R dot n hat DS. So DS is DY DZ. Okay. Then what is n hat here on this surface? What is n hat? Along x it is I hat. I hat is in this direction. J hat is along this direction. And k hat is along this direction, this z. Now the surface is here. What is the projection? So what is n here? Tell me. What is n?
K cap. K cap.
No. So if along x direction, it is I hat, I cap. N hat is what? In this direction, I cap. Okay. In this direction, it is I cap. So here, it is minus I cap. What is this? This is minus I cap. See, this is the this direction. This is the this direction. In this direction, it is I cap. And in the backward direction, what is the value?
Minus I cap.
So if I say, if I now do if I take this plane, see this plane, that means G F E D, this plane, G F E D, this plane. So what is the value of n hat in this plane?
I cap.
Okay, so tell me, today is not possible to complete this problem. Now here, tell me, so I'm just solving your problem of the direction of n hat. Now if A, B, F, E, this is the surface, A, B, F, E, this is the surface, what is the direction of n hat? What is n hat?
J cap.
So A, B, F, E, on this surface, A, B, F, E, on this surface, what is n hat? N hat is J cap. So E, the just opposite surface of this, that means O, C, G, D, on this surface, what is n hat?
Minus J cap.
Okay, minus J cap. Again, two surfaces remaining. What is the two surfaces? This is F, B, C, G. This is the surface. F, B, C, G. This is the surface. What is the value of n hat?
K cap.
Because it is along the Z. So projection. So n hat equal to K cap. And it is just opposite to this. That means what? O, X, E, A. O, X, sorry, O, D, E, A. Just opposite to this. Okay. So what is this?
Minus K cap.
Okay. So in this way, the projection we can calculate. So in OABC, it is what? OABC for the first surface that I have taken. OABC. Nato? OABC. Okay. OABC. So for this, what is, so come to the, so I'm writing this one. So I'm writing in brief. So the integration, what I will write? Dy dz. What I will write? Dy dz. Okay. Then what is r dot n hat? R dot n hat equal to what? R equal to what? I hat x? R dot n hat. What is this? R equal to what? I hat x plus j hat y plus k hat z. N hat is what? On this surface, OABC, n hat is what?
Minus i cap.
Okay. So dot of minus i cap. So take the dot product. What you are getting?
Minus x.
So minus x. So what is this? R dot n hat equal to
minus x.
Okay. So OABC, here R dot n hat equal to minus x. And tell me in this position, what is the value of x on this surface? X, what is the value? Because this is dy dz. Plane. And what is x here? X is zero.
Zero.
So actually r dot n hat equal to what?
Zero.
Zero.
So r dot n hat, that is equal to minus x. Actually, as on this surface, x is zero, then actually here it is in this position. Here it is r dot n hat. So here it is what? Zero into this. Okay. So what was the integration? Surface integration of r dot n hat dy dz. And r dot n hat, what is the value? Zero. So zero into dy dz. Ultimate value is what?
Zero.
Okay. So in this way, taking every surface, you can do it. Understand? So how many surfaces are here?
Six.
So six times you have to integrate. So how many times you have to integrate? Six times. And at last, what you will do? You will add this 6 integration. You will add this 6 integration and finally you have the answer. Okay? Take one a surface, each surface, one each surface you will take. Where is this in that surface? First calculate what is ds. Okay? Then after that calculate what is n hat. Take the projection, what is n hat, calculate. Then calculate r dot n hat and also calculate there what is the value of x, y and z. What is the value of x, y and z? That also calculate. Tell me on DEFG surface. DEFG surface, what is the value of x? On DEFG surface, what is the value of x? This surface is here. This is origin. This is x and it is all. So what is this value? OD? X equal to 1, y equal to 1, z equal to 1. This is cube. It is shown though. So what is OD?
1.
So this is x. So GFED on this surface, what is the value of x?
1.
Understand? So in this way, for every surface, calculate the value of x, y and z. Calculate n hat from there. Calculate what is ds from there. Put all the values, calculate then for every surface, and you have total 6 surfaces. For 6 surfaces, each of which calculate and add later, and you will get your final answer. Okay. So the PPT is actually, so this is the whiteboard and this is the actual PPT, and for every surface it is shown. So don't copy it. The procedure I have shown, do it yourself in your copy and calculate. So what is the answer given? At last 3. So in this way, so 6 integrations, 1 2 3 4 5 6, so adding all these 3, the answer is 3. So you will do it. The time is over, actually it is 10:56, and you have also next 11:56, and also you have next class. So my ending this class here. Okay, and all of you send your assignment in Google Classroom. Any sheet you can use, A4 sheet, paper, anything you can use. So just I need the scan copy. So ending my lecture here.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.